Power distribution modules are certainly nothing new in professional motorsport, and as time goes by and the price point drops down, we're seeing them more and more in club level and semi-professional motorsport. Now, the basis of the power distribution module is pretty simple. It replaces fuses and relays with solid-state electronics to switch the power supply to the various circuits around the car. Now, there's a lot of advantages in doing so. It simplifies the electronic installation inside the car, and it also improves reliability. One of the nice features that we like about power distribution modules is that you can set the fusing current for each of the circuits in the vehicle, and then if one of those circuits trips accidentally, you can then also have that circuit retry as many times as you wish. This means that if something trips accidentally and there isn't actually an issue with that circuit, you can have that circuit come back online. Particularly for a race car, this may be the difference between making it to the finish line or ending up stranded on the side of the racetrack. That aside though, there are some other advanced functions that are easy to overlook with a power distribution module that make them really valuable. In particular, by adding sensors to the power distribution module, such as an accelerometer, this allows the power distribution module to essentially sense if the vehicle has crashed, or alternatively, you can also sense if the vehicle is in a rollover situation. Under these conditions, you can then automatically disconnect the engine or make the engine stop running, or also disable the fuel pump. So this is added safety and helps to ensure that the fuel pump isn't going to be spraying fuel around the engine bay or even inside the driver compartment if the car is involved in a serious accident. At the same time though, we may not necessarily want to disable all of the car's electronics in a crash. For example, if you've got an electronically controlled fire suppression system, then you may want to enable that system and keep that powered up. And here we can also add temperature sensors or fire sensors so that the fire system can automatically be deployed. And this can be a lifesaver, particularly if the crash is bad enough that the driver is incapacitated. Another overlooked feature of the power distribution modules is that all of the currents on all of the channels can be logged. Now, that might seem irrelevant, but what we can do here is monitor the current draw on certain components over the life of the vehicle. What I'm meaning here is, let's take for example the fuel pump. When the fuel pump's brand new and it's in good condition, let's say for example it might draw 6 or 7 amps of current. As the pump ages and potentially degrades, what we tend to see is that the current draw from the fuel pump will increase. Now, by monitoring that current draw over the life of the vehicle, we can start to easily see when that pump is starting to fail, and we can pick up on that and replace the component before it actually fails. So if we're watching these sorts of aspects in the data logging from the power distribution module, it allows us to preemptively replace components, again, improving the reliability of the car out on the racetrack where it matters.
If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.